Drakmang ke Gorkha tum mahem lo la sedak itum humridam iksinang la ni tum bahini humridam po la sidang litum samenang lanang don thade donmani tum hok.
So here we have one of our brother, so he's going to explain about this Gorkha's house.
So may I know your name?
Yeah, first of all I would like to thank to our gaseous team for giving this opportunity or privilege to participate here as a community, ethnic village, in this ethnic village, and I myself Inesh Tamang, so I'm from Aksu members.
Okay.
So I would like to explain, this house basically is called Taregar.
Taregar.
It's written over there, Gorkha, Taregar. Okay. So this house kind of two-storied.
Okay.
So in hilly areas most probably, we used to construct this house made of stones and all.
Stones.
Stones are not available. Because of this we are constructing through this bamboo.
Okay.
So please.
Okay.
First of all, I can share some outer area.
Okay. This is called Dikki. Dikki, no?
So ancient time, we don't have this kind of machines and all.
Okay.
So whatever products or rice or paddy or, that gehu and all, we used to put there, and people young ladies, they used to, there is some holdings there, but it's not met over here. So we used to do through this.
Okay.
This is called Dikki, and that is, we used to call, this is also Dikki, but Dikki, a kind of Dikki, but we used to do by hand.
Okay, by hand.
And this is called Charki.
Charki, no?
So whatever we put dal, basically black dal or moong dal something.
So we put here,
and then like this.
Okay.
So once you do like this, it will come from another way.
Oh, is it?
So
okay.
Yeah, it's kind of traditional machines, charki.
Okay.
And this is our storehouse, granary storehouse. So whatever cultivation, paddy, something or any wheat or something. So we used to store in this. This is granary.
Okay.
And that is our traditional. In Nepali, it is called holo.
Holo.
Holo and zua.
Okay.
This is traditional. And this is cow shed.
Cow shed, no?
Yeah. So we call it
reception.
Okay.
Some guests, whenever guests from any other places they used to come, so we used to receive here.
Okay.
Guests.
Okay. This is called doko.
Doko, no?
Hilly areas, this used to be this kind of,
basket.
But there should be one namlo, it's not there.
It means to carry things and all.
Yeah, carry things even what is it called?
Firewood.
All firewood.
Rice.
Different kind of activities all this, whatever we have, we used to use at day to day activities. We used to have this called doko in Nepal.
Okay.
Bwari in the sense daughter-in-law. So our first daughter-in-law is to stay in this. There is one separate,
partitions
over here, but right now this partition has not been met because of area problem.
Okay.
So this is called Siri.
Okay.
So.
Kalau ulang lo deh, teman itu mio.
So this is called mokai. This is kind of a very, we call it our one of the traditional items.
Okay.
We can eat to consume raw also, and after crushing also, and we used to make powder or atta something that can be done as in what is called a traditional food. We used to call dhiro.
Okay.
So first of all, so this is our living room.
Okay.
And this is called pati.
Pati.
In Gorkha, it's called pati.
Okay.
Like during some offerings or some pujas and all, we used to use this kind of things for giving this kind of tikka or something,
okay.
Right? And it is kukuri.
Okay.
And this is pote, where women used to wear, married women.
Okay.
But now it's kind of fashion. Even unmarried or young ladies used to put.
Okay.
Used to put like this kind of we call it pote.
Okay.
And there is also kind of pote, and there is bigger pati.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
And this is our traditional clothes.
Clothes.
This
one. Okay.
So this
what
is like.
What do you call this one?
This is called makmali.
Makmali.
So I'm putting this one, like jacket and all, shirts and all, and this muffler and all. Used to put this one.
Okay.
And this is daura surwal. Daura and surwal. Okay, this is daura. This is for men.
Okay.
This is basically it's for men, but here it's for only kids. Wearing for kids.
Okay.
And this is for ladies.
Okay.
We call chawandi choli.
Okay.
This is for ladies. And this is also kind of coat and tie. Gorkha tie. Like tie in the sense, this is kind of muffler.
Okay.
So this is the very basic thing we are giving here. And all these are our traditional. Like we Gorkha have many branches. Like tamang. You can see here. This is khos chetri. Okay. Khos.
Okay.
And this is gurung.
Okay.
That one is thakuri. So that is tamang. So like this overall, there are so many four tribes. But right now we have only some basics. Most common tribes, whatever available in Karbi Anglong. So this is our traditional dish.
Okay.
So this is called sel roti.
Sel roti.
One of our traditional item.
Okay.
Sel roti. And.
Okay.
And. Yeah, this is called singki. Singki achar. It's made of carrot.
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 Dry carrot. Carrot, when it is cut down, we used to dry out the carrot.
Okay.
And after a few weeks, then we used to make like kind of chutney something.
Chutney, okay.
And this is gungru.
We have to eat raw one or like kind of?
No, like it's not raw, it's just cooking one. But even raw also we can.
Okay.
There are so many, you know, recipes. And this is gungru.
Okay.
Ethnic, right? Atil, we used to put the teal, rye, no?
Rye
and
nila,
we used to put carrot, no? Better carrot.
And what about this kukuri and all?
So this is basically for exhibition, cultural exhibition.
Okay.
So like, this is kind of one of our weapons, Gorkha weapons.
Okay.
So this is called the bigger one.
Okay.
So in Nepali, I mean Gorkha, this is used for cutting buffalo and that goat, I mean male goat.
Okay, okay.
So this is used, this is called for, in Gorkha, this is called mar.
Okay, okay.
So this is our largest one, and another small one. This is called sirupati. Sirupati in the sense it has small size here, and it go like this. Small one. This is called sirupati. This is also one of our traditional.
Okay, okay.
And the rest one is like it's for daily uses.
Okay,
okay. All the smalls and all.
Okay, okay. Yeah. Then thank you so much for explaining us beautifully, and I would like to thank all of you for giving us the opportunity to come here.
You're welcome, sir.